I did a gig in Patch Hog, Long Island.
Oh, it's very very close to where I grew up.
It's a beautiful area.
Yeah.
Very very rich, right?
Parts of it, yeah, for sure.
Wherever I was, it was near the music hall, I think, or it was in the theater. But what was interesting, it was a Joe Vesey joint, who's a very funny comic, writes all the Adam Sandler movies and stuff like that now.
Don't blame him for that.
I think the most recent ones have been okay, I thought. No? Okay. Well, so he set up this gig, and we get there, and it's like, we're treated, it's called the loading dock. So it's like the back entrance to this symphony hall or whatever the fuck it is that typically seats 1,000 people. We get there, we're like being treated like kings, order food, all this stuff. But I'm also such a moron that we have these computers in our pockets all the time, and I check weather maybe once a month.
Right.
Like, I don't ever, I'm not prepared with an umbrella.
I don't like checking weather because I know you're constantly disappointed.
It takes the fun out of guessing.
Exactly.
And also the repercussions out of not paying attention.
Right, yeah, yeah.
So I am constantly just unprepared. I've been, you know, rained on like it's the Truman Show, like
right.
just one pipe of rain completely on me. And then this time I'm heading out to Patch Hog, and it's 75 during the day. It's piping hot. I take the train an hour and a fucking half out there because I couldn't drive.
Yeah.
And probably was drinking. And I get out, and it's like winter when I get out to Long Island. It's just hardcore whipping winds.
Oh,
I'm in
no.
a t-shirt. I'm literally
You're wearing a t-shirt?
A t-shirt. Not even a sweatshirt. I looked at my sweatshirt and was like, oh, should I wear this? Or should I even bring this in my backpack? And I'm like, what are you, a faggot?
Oh.
Like, in my own head, calling me, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
So I'm like, you know, tough in the whatever. Listen, get out. I'm immediately freezing. I'm like searching for a Sports Authority or anything that I could buy a hoodie. The only place that's open, I went to a Mexican like chicken place to eat just to warm up.
To get warm, yeah,
yeah, because I had a half mile walk to the venue.
Oh my
and,
god!
Yeah, then I continue on my quest after thawing out, and I see a Dollar General store. I walk in, and there's two hoodies. They are both more neon than any color in the gas digital network.
Oh,
reactive.
But that's like your style. You
no,
wear those.
It isn't.
You wear that. You have that pink one. You know what I mean? I'm not.
I have a pale pink.
Yeah,
that's pale pink, and that's also in style with a camo overlay. The two colors go well together and are very in fashion.
Okay,
Dana, am I right or am I fucking right?
Yeah,
right. Okay, you're asking Dwight. What You're not wearing the mustard yellow.
Yeah, but she's all peacocking with her nose jewels.
Yeah, well, there is that.
Her schnoz jewels.
But here's the thing.
Hold on!
I know, but I'm saying, on a sidebar of that, I refuse to get a...
Did we catch that?
Nope, Dana wasn't
God
looking. I will never buy something if I misdressed.
Uh-huh.
I have to suffer the punishment of now. I don't get a do-over to just go pay my way out of a problem.
I'm also a guy that loves buying new things.
You like shopping.
I don't like shopping. I just like the feeling of filling an emptiness momentarily.
Yeah.
Obviously, all of my bad habits are that.
Yeah.
It's drinking, it's smoking, fucking, whatever.
Yeah.
You know, buying clothes. It's all momentarily like patching leaks in a day.
Comedy.
Yeah, it's all. I have never been more self-aware in my entire life, and I got to tell you,
this is the worst episode yet.
Yeah. I am deflated.
Finish your fucking cold story.
Oh, so I buy this thing. I immediately walk into the venue. Everybody's like, "Oh, hey, road sign or what? You know, what'd you do? Community service before you got here?
Classic Sandler.
Somebody turned off the." turned off the dressing room light by mistake, and I was glowing in the dark. I swear to God, it was a glow in the dark $3.99.
Like highlighter yellow?
Highlighter yellow. Pretty cool, actually, to be perfectly honest. And it's something that I plan on wearing again. But I caught quite a few guffaws for it. So we do the gig. The gig itself, it seats about 200, but it's in the room that seats 1,000. So they actually set up a small stage on the big stage and then sat chairs on the big stage. So the entire show...
It was like Nick News.
What?
With Linda Ellerbe. Remember that? Can you pull up a picture of that, please? It's a killer reference. Because it's Nick News.
I love that you trash me for mine.
This is a childhood thing that everybody gets.
I didn't have cable.
I'm sorry.
What was that? That was fucking disgusting.
You didn't have a good childhood. But there was this show called Nick News with Linda Ellerbe, which was way too serious. And it talked about very serious things. But what they would do is she would kind of talk in the middle as like a powwow.
Wait, was that the fat girl?
No, she wasn't. No, that's Lori Beth Dimberg. Okay. But they would sit in like a round. This is when it came back, so this isn't what I'm at all looking for, Dana. But this is, but and this is again, this is new. This is not helpful. Anyway, regardless, it was a good reference. People get it, or they didn't.
Nobody.
People type on.
I would beg.
Tweet us right now if you knew about Nick News. It was a she would sit in the middle and lecture a bunch of little kids that would sit around her, Indian style.
Okay.
Yep. It was a fucking great reference, and she didn't pull the thing up in time.
I mean, it could have also been like Wendy from Peter Pan doing story time in the tree. No. There's other references that more people would understand.
I chose Nick Jr. because it had a hard K and it's funny. So go ahead. That's when you want to make your Irish goodbye.